Hey everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Avadon the Black Fortress with me, Atantuo. We are still in Moritz'Kri's tower. The evil wizard who, well, now openly evil, who was responsible for creating the Shadow Beast, apparently, which we already suspected anyway. Okay, this door is locked. We need a key for that, so no exploring the tower cellars for now. Okay, this is the wine closet. Good to know. We have found an access to the central stairway, but I'm going to explore around first. Maybe I'll find the key after. Oh, and also this apparently leads to the sealed off area that I wasn't able to explore before. Let's see here. What is that? There's stuff to sell at the very least. Chain greaves. Yeah, that's all. Are those shoes? Yeah. No, they're not. They're leg armor. But still, old stuff. Please bear with me if I seem a bit slow to get into things. I have not played in a couple of days. It's not been that long, but I might not have all the details as to what exactly I've been doing right before I stopped playing last time. Anyway, so this is a dead end. Obviously, no need to linger for too much longer. So, still blocked off. Okay, here we have the what's it called? Storage areas. Pantry? I think. Not panty. One lockpick to succeed. Yeah, sure. Might have something interesting in here. We have an ancient scroll, I think. No, it's a group heal. Never mind. And take that anyway. Charm foe as well. Still haven't used that. Maybe one of these days. Maybe. Oh, a drake skin. Thank you very much. And an assault crystal. Sure. What have we in here? Nothing really. I can sell that leather jerkin, I guess. Okay. Dagger, short sword, gold ring. Thank you very much. Now you can keep your pipe. Oh, this is also unpickable. Okay, well, I guess that only... yeah, cellar stairs. We cannot access those yet, so let's go upstairs. And again, only one path to take. That makes things easier for us. Or for me, with my chronical indecision. One lockpick again. Okay, arcane scroll, worth it. Runestone of Purity. Dexterity. Well, okay. She's our roomkeeper. Oh. Tower apprentices. Now we start facing off against mages. Okay. They are relatively squishy, as one would expect from mages, I guess. Okay. Okay. His turn. What? I can't see them. Ah, too bad. Almost finishing enemies off is one of the worst things. Just in general. Oh, also Shima leveled up. When did that happen? Whoa. When did that happen? I didn't even notice. I mean, I noticed now. Let's see here. More strength? Sure. And now we can pump these some more. Now they're all up to the maximum attainable level for now. I don't know if I can actually put more points into this. I might be able to. We'll see though. Anyway, more damage. more crit chance, and more hit chance. Good. I like that. Oh, also, I don't need to be in combat mode anymore. So let's see what they were guarding here. Sapphire, fine cloak. No things on the ground. Here neither. Any documents that I might be interested in? Well, charm full scrolls. And an elixir of health. That might come in handy, actually. She gets a second one. Knife, wine. No, thank you. Okay, let's hope this continues. Oh, I guess it does. Or maybe not? Wait. What did it say? Turn the wheel. You hear in the distance steel scraping over stone. Oh. Okay. I guess I'm... Yeah. I opened this one. I see. More enemies, maybe? First, though... Nope. No interesting loot. I'm also trying to keep an eye out for switches on the walls. They're extremely tiny, though, so... I've probably missed a couple over the course of the game, but that's fine. There are corpses here, and the ground looks a bit scorched. This is yet another of Moritz'Kri's workshops. However, after the wizard fled the tower, something went wrong. Several apprentices were gruesomely killed here, but not until after they scorched the walls and floor with their attempts to defend themselves. You look around, trying to figure out what killed them. Then you hear squeaking from behind you. Oh. I also see those arrows there. The concealed beast that ambushed the apprentices emerged from the shadows behind you. Okay, that's fine. It's just bats, vampire bats. Okay. I guess I should spend some points and do this. Okay, well, it did kill one that was still at full health. That's good. That one's terrified. So let's get rid of that one first. Okay. Oh, riposte. Nice. Well, did not mean to go there, but that's fine. Okay, we killed that one. Oh, why didn't we... Oh, because it's a warp bat. Oh, I see. Dies like the rest, though. I'm not trying to say that we're the best or anything, but it did mess with us. Okay. Some minor loot, some more minor loot, maybe? Yeah, resurrection screw is actually not that minor. It's pretty useful. Okay. Another one of these gates opened. Okay, what'll we find here? Nothing yet. Also, oh no, never mind. No, no worries. I was just, oh, sticky imps. Okay. Well, they don't sound very, pleasant to fight, but I guess we have no choice. They also look fiery, so I guess they... took quite a bit of damage from the ice magic. Okay, that one just leaped. What's this one going to do? Nothing. Just fine with that. Oh, wait, you can't move at all. But I can attack. And I cleaved. Okay, they're not immune to fire. Good to know. In case I encounter any more of these. Yeah, well, why don't you... Oh, what? Oh, because she's ensnared. I get it. Okay. Let's see, no drops. Let's see, no switches. And we open up the... Yes, okay, well, that, there was some delay in displaying that. So, is this gonna be... gonna lead to another path upstairs? Let's see what's here first. Oh, there's the stairs. Speak of the devil. Okay, what have we here? Oh, I did not see those. They're camouflaged pretty well. Bed chamber sentinel, huh? I wonder what's behind the door. It's a mystery. Well, you're pretty sturdy. And you missed, but still knocked me back. That's interesting. So I guess Shima just jumped back to evade. That's my headcanon now. Nice. They drop gems. I like that. What have we here? Lightning scrolls. These are super weak. This one too. But I can't sell them. And I will. Just you wait. Okay. Is this going to unlock everything? It is not. Huh. What gate did that open? Maybe I'm missing something obvious? I don't know. The way up? Oh, two lockpicks. Yeah, sure. Definitely want to check out the mage's bed chambers. We get one lockpick back immediately. That's very much appreciated. Oh, a golden goblet. Sure. He won't need that anymore. Nope. I'm gonna sell that. And... one of lightning. I'm pretty sure I have several of those. Actually, you know what? Let's sell this one and take another fresh one. Just in case. Silver necklace, steel dagger, and... oh, okay, we need a key for that one. Okay then, further upstairs it is, for now. Oh, also, wait a second. Okay, yeah, I just had to make sure I see my timer. I should have paused the video, I guess, but I did not. So what's going to happen here? As you cross this oddly empty workshop, well, I wouldn't even call it a workshop, it looks like a ritual chamber or something. Well, of course, the gate slams shut behind me. A cloud of sulfurous smoke appears in the center of the room, blocking your vision. When it fades, the ring of torches has vanished. In their place you see a creature. It looks like a demon, sort of. Actually, it looks like a human that has been painfully altered by Moritz'Kri to be more demonish. Demonish. The thing is red, twisted, and covered with scales. It barely seems to recognize that you are here, that you're there. It stares at the ground and breathes heavily. Then it lets out a long, tortured gurgle. Its muscles tense. It starts to concentrate. Two things happen. The air around the beast starts to grow. The air starts to grow? Oh, pfft. Derp. Very hot. For some reason I thought that the sentence ended there. And an invisible hand starts dragging you slowly across the stone toward the creature. I was going to approach it anyway. Spiral fire demon, huh? Okay, so let's open with an disarming blow. Which I missed. That's fine. I guess the next step is triumphant roar. So we have that as long as we can. Spiral fire is probably immune to fire. Yes, of course. The demon thing concentrates harder. exerting the power infused into its body by Moritz'Kri spells. The invisible hands grabbing at you grow stronger. You slide slowly and inexorably across the floor toward the creature. We are already standing right next to it. Okay. Attack. At least we get a backstab off now. Let's try and stun it. Because why not? No, it resisted. That's fine. We can use a something blow. You move one step away and use your icy lance. It's also immune to ice. What? The demon thing continues to moan and mumble, its eyes glow red, the muscles in its face and neck grow taut. Then, with a final burst of effort, the air around the beast briefly catches fire. Everything near the creature is bathed in searing heat. Okay, so that's his dome. That didn't do very much. Feet feel like lead. Well, that's fine. Nice backstab. Wow, that was a lot of damage. Should I just attack normally? I guess so. And I can attack twice. So, maybe Searing Spray will actually do something? Yes, it did. And he is also acidified. Nice. Can I attack him? Maybe? Yes, okay. And it's already dead. With a final blow, the demon thing falls to the ground. The invisible hands release you. The air grows cooler. For a moment, the beast's mind returns to it. It looks up at you and rasps, "Thank you!" And then it expires. The magic holding your prisoner fades away, the gates slowly open. That wasn't so bad. Titan steel woven pants. Okay. They're reasonably good for pants, I guess, but that's it. I'm definitely not gonna take these over the ones that increase magical damage. But I'm going to hold... Whoops. Excuse me? Why? Ah. That was weird. Oh, wait a second. Ha! Never mind. I know what happened there. That might also explain some other problems I've had. Anyway, moving on. Nathalie looks into yet another workshop with scorched floors and magic circles and shakes her head. Oh, for the... Has Moritz'Kri ever, even once, exercised even a tiniest bit of restraint ever? Shima says, "Was I mistaken? It seemed that you admired this tower." Nathalie says, "I want a tower like this someday, yet I think three or four workshops are enough. More than that shows a dangerous lack of focus and discipline." Oh, she was just referring to the number of workshops, not to what he was actually doing in here. I guess different priorities. Oh, I was gonna say, the door's shut, so what's gonna happen here? And apparently the undead are happening. Once again, the gate closes behind you. Another of Moritz'Kri's experiments appears before you, ready for one final battle test. Actually, there are two identical experiments, one in each circle. They are humans, or were before the wizard infused them with who knows what bizarre magic. Their skin is blue, their mouths are full of fangs, and most interestingly, the two creatures are tethered by a long thin thread of magical light. The beasts step out of their circles and lurch toward you. Moritz'Kri has kept them hungry so that they attack intruders with great enthusiasm. Okay, twin-bound ghoul. Twin-bound. Does that mean that I'll have to kill them both in the same round, or they will revive? One of the twins stumbles, weakened by your attacks. The other looks at it with a strange, almost touching look of concern. The creatures maintain some human emotions. Then the stronger sends a pulse of energy along the thread of light to the weaker. The more damaged beast is revived. It gives its twin a faint grin of gratitude. So they just heal each other, I guess. Not that that isn't bad enough. Stun? No, stun resisted. Attack. Ouch. Savage blow. Critical. Very nice. Another critical. Okay, so it's not as bad as I feared. I guess I might as well just focus on one then. Although they might actually revive each other when I end up killing one before the other. One of the twins stumbles, weakened by your attacks. The other looks... Wait, we had that already. Okay. That didn't do very much, if anything. I'm fine with that, though. Attack, and attack, and attack. Okay, one is dead. Now we'll know. No, he does not revive. Can't say I'm not okay with that. And he's dead. Slaying the first... What? The first of the tormentors has caused horrible pain to the survivor after the loss of its partner. Death seems to come as a blessing. Mortally wounded, it crawls across the floor to its twin. Aww, that's pretty far, though. It reaches the other, grabs its hand, and expires. The gates slowly open. Oh man, that's pretty grim. A sharpshooter's mantle. Plus 10% missile damage. Interesting. But I don't think I'll ever actually have a missile damage focused character, so... There's that. Oh, the floor is lava, huh? Yep, sure is. A lava basin? I mean, I assume it's lava. Oh, we also have Initiate Vala, Initiate Tria, and Initiate Ixtari. Okay, well, seems like a good time to save. Oh, and as soon as I click on one, battle actually starts. I can only attack targets that I see, I know. I thought I was seeing him. Or her, or it. No, well. The sprites look... I don't know what they look like. I guess female-ish? Whatever. Not as... that it really makes any difference. Attack? Oh, nice. There are three people waiting in these alcoves, each standing in a magic circle. Each circle is flanked by a pair of tall, glowing red, glowing crystal spires. As you enter, they look at you with loathing. Moritz'Kri did not lie, says the first. The invader of Avadon has come. Atantuo is here, says the second. Let us show the might of the apprentices of Moritz'Kri. Let us prove ourselves, shouts the third, and then they attack. Man, are they stupid. Okie doke. And the first one's already dead. Come at me, dudes. Wonder if something's supposed to be up with these glowing crystals. Ah, that was almost enough. Almost. Okay, no debuffs, that's fine. One of the apprentices disappears in a cloud of shimmering blue sparks. Okay, he teleported to his circle. A moment later, he reappears in the stone circle. Then the crystals flanking the circle begin to pulse and hum. As you watch in horror, power flows into the circle. The energy quickly revives the apprentice. What? Oh, it just healed him a tiny amount. What's that supposed to accomplish? That really wasn't enough healing to make any kind of difference. Maybe the game is expecting me to be much weaker than I am at this point. Excuse me. Please don't charm my dudes. Come on. Attack. Why didn't Shima move? Now he's slowed. Okay. He still reached that guy. Come on. And keep missing. Thank you. The final apprentice of Moritz'Kri falls before your attack. You had predicted that the Chimerian wizard would be a harsh master, but it's horrifying how casually he's throwing away those sworn to his service. The gate in the northwest corner opens. You must be close to the top of the tower. Okay. Good thing charm ends as soon as the charmer dies, apparently. Okay. HP are regenerated. Let's go up. Could this be the final floor? Maybe? But I guess not. Well, maybe it is. You step out into the highest chamber. Yes, thanks for clearing that up, game. The highest chamber of Moritz'Kri Tower. It is a beautiful workshop, featuring the finest magical tomes and alchemical equipment. Many of the wizard's most delicate and powerful spells must have been cast here. However, you are disappointed to find that the wizard himself is not here. Instead, you find a robed woman in her 20s. She wields a beautiful carved wooden staff. She looks so furious that she can barely contain herself. She says, "I am High Initiate Helma, first of Moritz'Kri students. I will slay you for what you have done here today." Why? Helma stops short. Wait, why? Why avenge my fellow students? Why prove myself to my master? It is an honor to be allowed to do battle with you. Moritz'Kri abandoned you to die. He already killed his apprentices in Ogrim Tor. Helma stops and lowers her staff. I knew they died, but I thought... I should not believe you, but he did not take me. He left me here, alone. She looks up at you. This is not a good time and place to fight. If I leave, I will be avenged upon you. Avenged upon you? Only not today. Do you understand? What? Yeah, it's not a good time and place to fight, I agree. If I leave, I will be avenged upon you. Only not today. I'm not sure I understand that last sentence. Maybe I'm just being dumb. Let's ask her where the wizard is. I would not mind letting him kill you instead of me. The last I saw him, he was entering the caves below the tower. You will need a key. Once I am gone, it will not be difficult to find. Okay. Well then, go. Helma nods and lowers her staff. I hope the wizard kills you. Also, I wouldn't mind if you beat him up a bit as well. Now I feel like I should have killed her. Oh well. It's not like I really desperately need the experience or anything. She might have dropped something nice though. But then again, what do we have here? Okay, abilities have been recharged. That would have been nice in fight, I guess. And this healed us. Or specifically, it healed our vitality, which I'm glad it did. You open the strongbox. As you do, your fingers receive a slight shock. A spell was holding it shut, but the magic is quickly fading away. There are two things of interest. First, there is a sheaf of sheets of papyrus covered with dense writing. All of it is in an odd magical dialect. You can't understand it, but you are sure Avadon would be interested. Second, under the sheaf of papers, you find a key. It was hard to see. It is made of metal, but translucent. It seems to exist halfway between this world and another. You take everything. This is all very helpful, but Moritz'Kri still needs to be found. Well, I'm assuming now that this is the key to the cellars. So that should help in finding him. Of course, now we have to backtrack through the entire tower here. That shouldn't take too long. Yeah, not too long at all. Okay, let's hope the key fits. Also gonna take a quick look at it. Special items, spectral key. Yeah. Okay. Nothing new there. And it fit, of course. Let's save. And Moritz'Kri's Shade. Hey, long time no see, old buddy. Once again, you find one of Moritz'Kri's Shades placed here to greet or spy upon those who visit the caves under his tower. It takes some time, but the wizard finally looks through the eyes of his shade, of this shade, sees you and begins to speak. You passed through the tower. That means that all of my apprentices are dead. Unfortunate, but necessary. Really? Was it, though? I will expect to see you soon. Yeah, really, I don't know. I don't really want to talk to him, but I have to. You wanted me to destroy your apprentices? Callous, I know, but they knew too many of my secrets. Okay, why have apprentices in the first place then, if you're so worried about your secrets being kept? That doesn't seem to make much sense, but then he is the mad wizard, right? So, I guess that's the reason. They could not be allowed to compete with me or to reveal what they knew to the pact. It was a risk they accepted when they came here. Really, was it in their contract somewhere? Though I confess their grim fate was far more likely than they realized. Well then, I guess I'll destroy him. Moritz'Kri, expecting this, abandons the shade. It becomes motionless a moment before your blow shatters it. Shortly after, there is another earthquake, strong enough to make you think that the tower is about to collapse above you. You hear the stone of the spire groaning and crackling. And then the tremor ceases. Something has happened. Something powerful. Ooh. Wait, I just want to check. Did the tower actually collapse? No, it did not. Okay. Not sure if that kind of modification to maps is even possible in this engine. I wouldn't expect it to be. Never seen anything like it so far. That's why. Watch bat, huh? And one infernal bat. Well then, why don't you... Oh, it can just breathe fire through these stalagmites. Okay. Nice crits. Assuming the infernal bat is going to be fire immune. Oh well, it shouldn't matter. And it wasn't even. Okay. Drops, bat nest, animal skin, thank you. So which way do I want to go? Oh, I've already... wait, I can just take a look. What was this? Oh, yeah, I remember. So, this is actually connected. Interesting. I can also do this, I recently learned. Just hit the number keys and jump to the characters if they're off screen. It's pretty useful. We have a trap here that I was of course able to disarm. I have yet to see a single trap that I failed to disarm. I mean, I am at my maximum possible trap disarming and lockpicking skill, that being only 4, I think. So I don't know if there's even any random chance involved. This was a huge, lovely cavern, featuring a peaceful lake and a forest of delicate stalagmites formed by countless centuries of dripping water. Someone has been smashing down the stone formations and replacing them with rows of cages. The cages are currently clean and empty. When the work was completed, Moritz'Kri would have had the space to massively expand the scope of his twisted experiments. Happily, you have interrupted the process. It is full of rats, though. However, they are not hostile yet? Squeak. Okay. I'll let you squeak in peace, then. Where do I want to go, though? I cannot go this way, but I can explore... this way first. I'm somehow expecting or assuming that I need to go towards this area and I'll end up emerging in that walled off or closed off northwestern part of the main map. What is this? Try to open the sarcophagus. Oh, it's oddly... I don't know. Plain looking, I guess. However, the moment you touch it, a powerful chill starts to spread up your arms. With difficulty, you pry your frozen hands loose. Interesting. Does that actually do anything? Doesn't look like it does. Oh, we have another one, though. With some incense in front of it. You try to open the sarcophagus, it takes a massive amount of effort and straining, but you manage to dislodge the stone lid. As it clatters to the floor, something rises from within. Something very angry to have been imprisoned for so long. It has not been imprisoned by me, but undead usually don't care about that. About that kind of detail. It's dead, though, and it made me level up. Yay. More intelligence, and... I'll keep pumping... What skills exactly? Do I want more lightning? This is at maximum. More crit chance sounds good, so I guess I'm going to do this. Yeah. Okay. Still nothing here? Nope. Okay. And no drops? Nope. And this just connects. Cool. Good to know. There are some Harmon's watch beasts. Harmon? Who's Harmon? Someone I haven't met yet. And we have another sarcophagus, which I'm also going to desecrate, of course. Oh. Was a mass grave, it looks like. You try to open the sarcophagus as the lid clatters to the floor. A cloud of choking snow and dust flies out of the sealed crypt. Several creatures rise from within, all very angry to have been imprisoned for so long. Okay, so these are... No, they're the same kind of vengeful bones. Okay. I was expecting, like... Oh, maybe they are ice elemental. I guess they might be. Okay, attack. Attack. Vulnerability curse. Oh well. Nice crit. Finish that one off, please. Weakness curse. Come on. I can still crit. And that is that. Okay. Enemies are visible, yes, but they are not not aggroed yet. Okay, got a short sword from somewhere. Oh, that's Beastkeeper Harmon. It looks like a woman, actually. Was not there before, wasn't she? Maybe just out of my line of sight. Okay. I'm always happy when enemies are not actually... Oh, that's still not hostile, okay. When enemies turn out not to be fire immune, even though they look like they might be. Backstab and war curse and try to stun. Maybe one of these days stun is actually gonna work. Not today though. Okay, we got something ensnared. That's fine though. We don't really need to move away at all. Backstab, savage blow, and kill? Ah, not quite. That's the worst. Yeah, finish her off. And the watch beast takes a last breath and dies, and we level up, and I scroll away involuntarily. Okie doke. He needs more damage. Oh, I can actually put more points in there. I didn't expect that to be the case. Huh, I guess that might actually be what I want to do, or, well, now that I think about it, no, that's good, it also improves stunning bash. I'm gonna do that now. It should really help in the long run. Sapphire ring and a ruby ring. Well, I've had several of those already, but sapphire ring is new. 25% poison and acid. It's quite a bit of resistance. Plus strength and melee damage is, of course, superior. Energy and mind effect resistance. Well, I don't know which one's really better. This is more overall resistance. And poison and acid are also probably the most dangerous for someone with low HP, such as her. So I guess I'm gonna do that. Oh, we have another trap here. I didn't even go down this path. Let's see. We have another lockpick. Nice. And some nondescript tools. Look like tongs to me, but what do I know? I'm no expert. Okay, this is the cave I had already seen. A corrupted hellhound and two watchwolves. Oh wow, those watchwolves are weak as heck. In fact, they're already dead. So, oh, what? That one too. I did not expect that thing to die, to basically die in one single blow. It looked a lot stronger than that. Okay. Let's check this nest, some coins, lightning scroll is bad. I have no use for that. A lovely crystal, I can sell. Oh, what have we here? Oh, this is behind the closed gate, and this is the stairs up that I was expecting. Just making sure. What's on the table here? Arcane scroll, thanks, and an apprentice rod. Okay. Now, is this going to open some kind of shortcut here? Iron gauntlets, sure. Oh wow. Lots of stuff to sell. Lots of stuff to sell. Wow. Too bad the daggers don't sell for anything. Also, what's up with this rune here on the floor? Oh. Looks like another elixir of health here. Thank you very much. Well, didn't know he was already carrying three of those. Oh, that's fine though. They don't really need to be spread out completely evenly. It's not like I drink them a lot anyway. Ideally, I'll never even need them in the first place, but of course, that cannot be guaranteed. So, what have we here? Is this gonna be another trap? Also, oh, there's a locked door here. Not an ordinary one either. There is a large glowing rune of protection etched into the floor in front of it. Wisps of light float up from the rune and waft toward the door, promising a bad day for anyone who wants to pick the lock. A bad day as in it's gonna explode and kill him, or a bad day as in it's not going to open? Okay, the latter. That was another vitalizing basin. Thanks game, for that, even though it was not strictly necessary. Okay, well, I really hope that I'm going to finally get a ways of opening these rune-protected doors. I mean, where else would I get it, if not in the domain of a powerful wizard, right? And I did actually emerge here, and there is Moritz'Kri himself. The man himself. What does it say? Infernal portal. Oh, that's not good. Wait, what? Oh, wrong button. That's what. I did mean to save. Okay. And there is also some kind of demon already summoned. You have found Moritz'Kri at last. Not in time, though. The ritual he fled to his tower to perform... what? The ritual he fled to his tower to perform is complete. He is no longer alone. He stands fearlessly in front of a dark portal. A dark, very bright, shining portal. It is a tear, in reality. Beyond the veil, you can faintly see a blackened landscape of lava and bones. It is the creature standing in the portal, however, that draws much of your attention. It is a demon, enormous, muscular, and full of raw power. It stands in the portal almost as if it is stuck, or its Kri, the mad wizard who called it from beyond, is standing there talking to it. What are they talking? I don't know. I'm gonna open this gate first. Okay. And I'm gonna open this gate also. Don't know why, but I might as well do it now. The game allows me to, even though it's a bit silly. Okay, fine cloak. Thank you very much. There's always time to loot. I guess I'm going to approach from here. You walk up behind, or, well, actually right in front of Moritz'Kri, close enough to get a better look at what he has done. He has opened a rift to the infernal realms, and something is trying to come through, an enormous beast, a lord of the demonic realms. It struggles to push through, eager to spread terror and destruction, but something is holding it back. It is most of the way through, through the dark fissure, but a gossamer sheet of energy holds it back. It tries to claw its way loose, but the fields resist its mighty attacks. Your attempt to sneak up on the wizard unsurprisingly doesn't work. He turns to face you, exhausted and sweaty, but triumphant. Behold! Behold, Belloc the Scourge! Soon it will be in our world, under my command, ready to ravage the pact. Right, that sounds very, very reasonable. Summoning powerful demons never hurt anybody, or bit anybody in the back. I mean, what have you done? Are you mad? He's quite obviously mad, so I guess I'm going to go with the official Avadon speech here. Moritz'Kri, you are guilty of illegal magic. You must return with me to Avadon. Moritz'Kri laughs. I admire you, Atantuo. Even here, at the gateway to the infernal realms, you trust in the power of Avadon. But I have summoned Belloc to make your power meaningless. Today marks the beginning of the end of Avadon. Belloc the Scourge listens to this exchange and smiles. Once it is loose, you suspect that it will find a way of doing to your world whatever it wants. Well then, your demon appears to be stuck, friend. You are correct. He is trapped now, between one world and the other. To bring him the rest of the way, there must be a sacrifice. Souls of courage, bearing true power and strength, brought before him, their blood spilt on the gossamer bonds that hold Belloc back. Then he will be free, and at my command. Belloc, 15 feet tall and infused with the raw power of the infernal realms, shrugs. Okay. Why don't you sacrifice yourself? I considered it. I am no coward. If I thought it would end the pact, I would give my life in an instant. However, without me to control it, Belloc would go mad. All would serve to feed him, not just those of the pact. It is true. Oh, it is true, Belloc adds in a deep voice. I cannot deny it. Okay. And you think that you can sacrifice me? Is that what it is? I will. I will subdue you with my power. I will draw you to the portal. In your last moments of life, as you bleed from many wounds, I will feed you into the maw of Belloc. You will eat your very life essence. No, he will eat your very life essence. And he will break free from these bonds. So, now you will try to resist. It is your way. And then the end will come. Well, he's not going to reverse this experiment, so I guess I'm going to attack. We must return to Avadon or die. There is no other option. The question is, what's going to happen when we actually kill him? Will the demon get sent back to its dimension, or will it be freed and without a master? Well, we'll see, I guess. I have tired at last of your bravado. Do you not see that you have stumbled into your final... He shakes his head. Beads of sweat fly from his brow. Enough talk, it is time. Have at you. Belloc, Moritz'Kri shouts, serve me! The demon can only send a sliver of his power through the barrier to the wizard, but what he can give, he gives. Yes, the mad Chimerian says, at last, it is time! Okay. Good villain speech there. Well, good-ish. Belloc the Scourge is not actively part of the battle yet. I hope that's going to stay that way. Why don't you approach the wizard from the other side, just in case he tries to run away? And first of all, buff us all. We have no minions yet that I could charm. What could I do? Group heal now. One of corruption. I don't know. Let's see. Actually, why don't I do that? That's actually reasonably powerful. I don't need to do that though. Wand of Corruption on Moritz'Kri. Maybe it's gonna work. It did work. Good. Oh, and still her turn. Nice. Oh yeah, because that only took 5 points. Well then, attack. And a critical too. Once again, you are smacking Moritz'Kri around. However, instead of in Karstarl's throne room, you are in his home ground, standing before a demon he summoned. Moritz'Kri calls out, Belloc, I command you, give me shielding from beyond. Belloc looks at you and shrugs, as if to say, what can you do? Then he pokes at the membrane that holds him out of your world. Imps start to appear in a circle around you. As each appears, a faint shield of energy appears around the wizard. Okay, so now there are going to be adds that I'll need to destroy. Moritz'Kri looks to Belloc. You want to be trapped here? You want to be trapped there? If not, I require stronger aid. Oh, I guess I damaged him too much in one single round. So two events trigger at once. Belloc nods. I suppose that is part of the bargain. I have no shortage of irritable souls stored away. Once again, the demon pokes at the membrane of energy that holds him in. Infernals begin to come through. When they arrive, they are small and delicate. However, they immediately begin to grow. So are two waves of imps now gonna spawn, or... Maybe? But is Moritz'Kri really shielded now? That's the question. I guess I'll never find out. Oh, pfft. Or I miss. That's an option. Why can't he move freely? That's not nice. Curse ward imp. I'm assuming that I actually do have to kill at least some of these adds. Of course, he resisted stunning. That's fine though. Well, that. Actually, that was a lot of damage. All of a sudden. Okay, that imp is poisoned. Oh, nice. Hasted. So, might as well do this. With the points that I have left. You drink something, and. I guess. Keep attacking the wizard. He's almost dead now. Moritz'Kri stumbles back, beaten and bloodied. He looks over at Belloc, who watches impassively. Demon, do you want into our world or not? Save me! Belloc smiles. And if I save you, will you give me what I ask? Everything! Moritz'Kri cries. Everything! Belloc laughs. Everything? How can I refuse such an offer? He pokes at the membrane, and a pack of the Hounds of Hell are unleashed. They are much reduced in strength from passing through the barrier, but they are still deadly. Ooh, I'm shivering. However, please don't miss. He's still immune. Ah, goddammit. Steel Ward Imp, huh? Is that the one I need to kill now? Corrupted Hellhound. Ah, this is annoying. Okay, let's... Cannot quite reach all of them. That's unfortunate. That one looks fiery. What to do, what to do. Growing demon. Guess I should kill it. Oh, come on, really? Oh, that was a terrible round. Yeah. Attack it. Okay. As long as you. Well, she was hit. Okay, now it starts to become annoying. For a second there, I was hopeful to end this fight in a timely fashion, but now things are looking just a bit grim. We have all these ward imps here that I'm not a huge fan of. Okay, these can be killed by fire magic, that's very good to know. And it did me the favor of leaping closer here, actually. Okay, please don't kill her. I guess that's not... I think that was a damaging spell in the first place. Okay, what do I do now? Yeah, enemy stops me. I was expecting that. Curse Ward. You're also pretty beaten up. Guess I'm gonna do this. And... should I heal? Should I risk not healing? I'm gonna do this. Maybe that's a mistake. You attack the Hellhound. Oh wow, she's dying. I need to use this. Good thing I have those. She could also have used this one. In fact, she can still use it. Okie doke, what else? Could also use another corruption. And hit these three enemies, maybe kill the Hellhound. Oh, come on. Of course, I missed that one. Okay, finish that one off. And that one? Good. Very good. You kill that one. And that one. Now we have no shielding imps. Good. Haha, that worked out really well. Moritz'Kri falls to his knees. His protector has failed him. His strength has faded. He falls backward and crawls toward Belloc, hoping for aid. Please, Belloc, help me! No, wizard, Belloc intones. You promised me everything, and everything is what I shall have. He reaches out, using all his strength, and his clawed hand stretches the membrane holding him until a small hole appears in it. He grabs Moritz'Kri around the wrist. As the wizard screams in agony and pure terror, Belloc pulls him through the barrier and into the infernal realms. Then the battle is done. The wizard has gone, Belloc's imps disappear. You are left in the arena staring at the demon, who shows no signs of going anywhere. Your mission is completed, and the demon lord is held in place. You are free to return to Avadon now, or to come back and deal with the demon when you have gained strength. Oh, I see, so Demon is now an optional boss, huh? That's interesting. I mean, I assume that's what it is. Oh, and we get an achievement too. Experiments concluded. Yes, I guess so. Two intelligence. Well, that's a straight upgrade, if I ever saw one. And the sun's rod. Come on, really? That's less damage. I mean, it does give 8% magical damage, so that might make up for the slight decrease in base attack power. That's really silly. I mean, 75 to 215. My plain wizard staff does 76 to 218. Fire resistance, magical damage. It should be better, all things considered. Can I see the... Wait. Well, it's also not yet enchanted. Do I have a rune to put more int on it? Not int, magical damage. Yes. Okay. Good. I'm gonna do that as soon as I return home. Which, I guess I should do right now. I'm done here. Just out of curiosity, though. There is nothing else left on the ground. Okay, I'm gonna save. And I'm gonna see what actually happens now. Now that Moritz'Kri is dead, Belloc the Scourge stands before you. The magical bonds hold it in place. It seems like it could step back through the portal if it wanted to, but it doesn't. The demon looks down at you and smiles. Being near it makes you feel the same existential terror you felt when you faced the dragons in the Kva. Did I feel that kind of terror? I guess I did. You realize that you don't need to fight this creature yourself. You can always leave it for Avadon's mages. So, it rumbles, we are at an impasse. Why don't you tell me about yourself first? I am Belloc the Scourge, commander of the Fifth Circle and the Black Realms. I have killed and been slain times beyond counting in our constant warfare, in my realm, this realm, and beyond. How did you come to be so high a rank? Through my raw power and utter mercilessness. If you don't believe me, you may try my strength at any time, mortal. How old are you? I do not know. All memory of my brief mortal life faded long ago. Perhaps it is a mercy. It is sad, though, that you could not be properly sacrificed to me. Yeah, I regret that too. And why do you regret it? I wish to take your memories, feed upon them, live them, enjoy them, feel all of your secrets. It is the closest to wonderful mortal life my kind can have. And then, when I am done, I still have your mindless husk to enjoy as a snack. Well, that sounds pretty pleasant. Too bad I can't really comply. Well then, anything else? What did you mean, an impasse? Moritz'Kri invited me into your realm. True, I have not been able to fully enter. He distastefully pokes at the magical barrier with a long claw. But you can't drive me out either. I will stay here until I find a way into your world. Didn't Moritz'Kri force you to come here? He invited me. True, it was an invitation I would have found very difficult to resist. The truth is that I wanted to come. Once I tricked and destroyed the mad wizard, I would have had a wonderful time. Why do you want into our world? Not that great, you know. Because your kind is such soft and easy prey. I wish to roam your lands. I can take much and eat much before you find a way to banish me. Why don't you just go back where you came from? I could. I choose not to. I see a rare and wonderful opportunity in your world. I can drive you back. Belloc was waiting for those words. Really? He seems to grow before you. No, wait, he is growing. The air grows hot and foul. You struggle to keep from gagging. It is all you can do to keep from fleeing in terror. You can challenge me. Try to drive me back. Risk my taking you in and feeding on you. Is that what you want? You see that you are facing a truly worthy and extremely dangerous foe. Oh, I... I'm sure it is. Well, commanding him in the name of Avadon will probably not make much of an impression on him. So I'm going to leave for now. I am going nowhere, mortal. I like it here, and here I will remain. Okay, I will come back for you, buddy. I could try and attack him just for fun. See how quickly he kills me. And the episode is growing slightly long. But, yeah, let's just try it. I can drive you back. Your time is done. You draw your weapons and approach. Your duel begins. Barrier grows thinner. Two gibbering monstrosities. Oh, that coward doesn't want to fight alone, huh? Wait, I don't see the monstrosities. Quite yet. Let's see, can I damage him? Well, I can. Excuse me? What? Oh, derp. I changed her weapon. And here we have Titan abominations. I've not yet met Titans in the main game, or... Well, this is still the main game, I guess. Backstab. Yeah, I'm not dealing a lot of damage at all. But I am dealing damage. And... I really wanted to see if he's immune. No, he's not immune to fire. That's surprising for a Demon Lord. Okay, we're stunned and... Oh my god, that was a lot of damage. Yeah. How strong are these? Not as strong as their master. Ouch. Ouch, okay. Yep. Yep. Okay, that didn't go very well. Attack! Stun, lose turn. Wait. Oh, they banished me up there. And he's dead. And the whole game just froze up. Oh! This is the first time I see the screen, actually. Did I really never die before? I guess in the one or two situations where I might have died, I actually chose to reload before it really happened. Service to Avadon is a true honor, and the rewards are great. Wealth, power, sometimes even fame. But there is a downside as well. The risk of ending up in the crypts deep below the Black Fortress. Alas, your journey in Avadon's service has come to an end. Redbeard and his servants will have to fight the conspiracy against the Pact without your help. But don't give up. Perhaps, knowing what you know now, you can prevail against your foes, rise and fight again in the service of Avadon. Yes, I think the knowledge I gained was do not attack Belloc the Scourge at level 21. Or 22, I guess. Okay, anyway, that's gonna be it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, please hit like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you real soon. Till then, have a wonderful time, and bye-bye.